Hey guys.
Thank you.
Hey guys.
Hey guys. And what is going on? Uncle Vatred here. And it is time for more techs. I see we've got a couple of Joe Estevez high heads in the house. So how's everyone doing tonight? Popcorn and pop already. Love to see it. But yeah, we're on the hunt for Joe. And the only thing we have to figure out tonight is whether tonight will be the night we see him. And I'm sure hoping that it is. Now let me get everything ready to roll here real quick. And hopefully this all works all right. There we go. And tried to test out the capture as best as I could, and oh, it shows up about pretty good proportion on the screen. I'll take it. That's about, I think, the best off-the-rip capture we've had for Tex. Oh, when it's Access Software Incorporated, you know it is gonna be a banger. So we were last in the office because we weren't sure what to do with ourselves. But I now know what we must do. But yep, we just got the nice quiet ambience of Texas office here. We can see if we got the new issue of Boyd's Life or not, I guess.
Extreme Sports Illustrated is pretty cutting edge. The last issue had an article on Ultimate Chess. 30 men and 2 women in a literal fight to the death.
Wow. The same monologue about Extreme Sports Illustrated. So we know about Sonny Fletcher, but we need to go back to the warehouse. Because we missed some stuff. So we're going to walk over here. Right over to the pillow. Aha!
Linsky must have had trouble sleeping. These prescription pills would knock out an elephant.
Ooh, he's got elephant trank. Linsky had the good shit. Hello, I don't have much time. That's okay, Maya. I'm glad you could come out to the stream and say hey. Even if it is for just a little time. How are you?
Appears to be an inbox, but curiously, I don't see an outbox.
So we gotta climb the ladder, move the box, move the calendar, and we find... I'm more happy to be here. Well, there is no shame in that. It's always a good time at the Uncle Vatred stream.
Several items are inside the safe.
All right, we got several items from the safe here. Let's pick them up all at once. And then... I think we found the thing on the fax machine. There might have been something about a note... Get on your tiptoes, Tex. I'm gonna go again. Talk to you later. Have a good stream, brother. Well, hey, have a good day at work or class. I don't know what you've got on tap for today, but I hope it's a good day, Maya. And thanks for stopping again. You You'll have to come back for, if only for Joe Estevez. He's a real treat. Because we're getting dangerously close to the Joe. I mean, and imagine being Greg Turkington.
This door is the only way in and out.
During the Valentine's Day special, pitching his deck of cards movie. His movie was so bad that Joe Estevez, who did Tex Murphy Overseer, wouldn't do Greg's movie. Let's go back to the office. We gotta get to work on some stuff here.
Well, this is a life insurance policy taken out by Carl Linsky. And the sole beneficiary is Sylvia Linsky.
Ah, I see.
That's a pass card reader. You attach it to a computer, then use a pass card on it.
So we got the pass card reader.
These cut up pieces resemble a rectangular security card, but it looks like a piece. I'm willing to bet this project of Linsky's figures.
And we got the sleeping pills.
Linsky must have had trouble sleeping. Well, this fact raises a few questions. First, who's SF? Second, was he working for Linsky?
Alright, so we have a few other things there. Can try to go to Sonny's.
Finding Sonny Fletcher's address was no problem, but Sonny wasn't there. I had to try again later.
Yep, we're going to have to try again later. We could go back to Dolores.
So what can I do for the world's sexiest PI?
Insurance policy?
That was Carl's way of making amends to Sylvia. And I'm sure it's the only reason Sylvia has you investigating her father's death.
Okay, that's all we've got, so. End the conversation. Maybe we go back to
Texas.
Sounds
like I've got a message on the vidphone.
Ah, Tex has a message on the vidphone. Somebody finally called Tex.
Hi, Tex. I need to talk to you as soon as possible. Could you come over to my father's house whenever you get this message? No matter how late it is.
Oh.
I'll be waiting for you.
I think...
Ah, the mating call of the blonde bird of prey. Well, I guess it goes without saying you ran right over there.
If I'd known how dangerous the situation was, I would have stopped to buy a gun. Turned out Sylvia had been talking to Mr. Absolute all evening.
Mr. Absolute. Ooh. And she looks like she is absolutely hammered. I mean, is Mr. Absolute like Bill Cosby or something? What the fuck was that? Like, oh, I gotta keep drinking.
Oh, look you, it is. Oh, look who it is. Tex
look
Murphy
who it is.
CPI on the case from hell. I bet you've solved this damn mystery by now, haven't you?
Oh, it'll take a few minutes.
And here I am. Sylvia Linsky, the bereaved client whose daddy took a dive into the San Francisco Bay.
Into the San Francisco Bay.
Sounds interesting, doesn't it?
Sounds like you've had too much to drink.
Oh, don't tell me I've had too much to drink.
No, Tex, she's had an... She needs more. She might confess.
More than you know.
That's just the grief, Tom.
What do you know about grief? Huh? Is your daddy dead? Did your mom walk out on you before you could even pronounce your own name? Huh? I didn't think so. You know what it's like to be absolutely alone?
Absolutely
That's why
alone.
I'm now alone. I don't have anybody now.
Sylvia, I'm really sorry.
Don't pity me. I don't need you. I don't need anybody. Go away.
What it you don't go need away. Is any more of this. What you do need is some Betty Pie.
Oh, Mr. Murphy, I'm surprised at you taking advantage of a woman who's had too
much. Oh no, boys,
drink.
Tex is about to get me too'd. This ain't good.
Sylvia, I require my victims to be at least sober enough to sign a waiver.
Oh, fucking ultimate Chad, Tex Murphy, says no to date rapery, and he's all about, like, the sex contract.
I like you.
He's gonna get written consent. What a Chad.
You're no fun. Not one bit.
Good night, Sylvie.
Good night. I like you too, Tex.
Oh, she likes us.
You're not gonna like anything in the morning.
Yeah, you're gonna be hungover.
You know, when we first met, it wasn't all that different from your night with Sylvia. But of course, you were the one that was sloppy drunk.
What? You're talking about the Bastille Day celebration at the Bruin Stew? I wasn't that drunk.
Oh, no, we met before Louis' party. Don't you remember? Come on, sweetie.
Oh, I do remember something, but I thought that was a dream. It's all kind of fuzzy.
Oh. Are we about to get the
okay,
joke?
Buddy. Come on. Time to go home.
Louie.
No.
Louie, one more.
Hey,
huh?
Hey, let's get going, bud. Come on. Morning, you've got places to go. I've got... Oh, come on.
The
guys,
fuck is this, Tex?
Look at what you've done.
Just
my
sitting
stand.
There, like at your office,
no,
but just fucking repainted.
Get your hands off me, you pervert!
Oof.
Yeah, I guess that wasn't a very promising start.
Now I know why I don't remember. You punched me. I mean, my jaw hurt for a week, and I never did figure out why.
Hey, guys.
Well, it was kind of a down period in my
Cheeto
life.
Juice.
Hey, guys.
Well,
welcome.
Things have gotten better. Haven't they?
Yeah.
With a shower
hey
of
guys.
Hey, guys.
Oh, but I'm dying to find out how you went from the starched, pressed young PI to a puddle of drool. Let's hear some more about your story.
Well, you're making it sound so glamorous.
Hey, guys.
You come?
After
hey, guys.
Sophia.
Hey, guys.
Well, the next morning, Dolores Lightbody contacted me. She had gotten
hey, guys.
An appointment with Arnold
hey,
Sternwood
guys.
Out at the North Hill Clinic.
Hey, guys.
And I went out to see him.
Hey, guys. Hey, guys. Hey, guys.
Hey,
guys.
Mr. Your Unc Bucks
hey, guys.
Spend just fine.
Hey, guys.
Take long, will it?
Hey, guys.
Extremely full docket.
Hey, guys.
Dr. Murphy.
Hey,
won't
guys.
Be taking long, will it?
Hey, guys.
He's got
hey, guys.
An extremely full docket.
Hey, guys.
Well, I'm going to be like, well, that makes two of us. Let's get down to brass tacks here.
Well, don't worry. I got to make it quick because I'm double parked out
hey, guys.
In the emergency room.
So, what can I do for you?
Fucking Giga Chad Tex Murphy double parked in front of the emergency room. Get right to the point.
Okay, well, that's enough small talk. Now, did you or did you not have anything to do with the murder of Carl Linsky?
It's my understanding Carl's death has been ruled a suicide. I don't know what else to tell you. Is there anything else?
Is there anything else?
Well... What's it like to be director of North Hill? Bet you got some horror stories to tell, huh?
I feel fortunate to hold this position, in light of our ranking as one of the world's finest medical facilities.
Oh, I'm just looking at this world-class medical facility in the background, and I'm like, what the fuck? So...
So can you tell me what Carl Linsky
yeah, what
did
Linsky
around
do?
Here, using words I can understand?
When he was younger, he was one of the very best neurosurgeons. Do you know what that means?
Neurosurgeon?
For the past few years, he worked mostly
you know
in research.
You know what that means?
Now, I don't mean to be unaccommodating, Mr. Murphy, but I really do have urgent matters to attend to.
Look. Sorry, can I just have a couple of minutes?
Jeez, yeah, a couple minutes, but I want to ask you about a lot of fucking shit. I don't know what's going to be the... Well, maybe he would know about the North Hill Clinic.
I consider it an honor to work here in light of the clinic's well-deserved
reputation. This is the clinic, yeah. So, he knows about that.
Carl worked here for 26 years.
Yeah, Carl.
Over the past few years, his age forced him to give up surgery in favor of research. We were friends, though not extremely close. I was sorry to learn of his premature death. I don't know who that is.
All right.
I've never heard of it.
Okay. What about Wanda?
Miss Peck works for Capricorn. While I respect her professionalism and the ideas of the organization for which she works, I don't look back on our brief association with any fondness.
Okay. Arnold Sternwood?
I assure you, Mr. Murphy, I had no part in the death of Carl Linsky.
And about Dolores?
I believe she was Carl's fiancée, as well as the executor of his will. I didn't know her prior to Carl's death.
Okay, okay. Capricorn, what's that all about?
About a year ago, Capricorn came to us, to Carl Linsky specifically, with allegations of unethical research practices. The charges were completely without merit. But Carl decided to take a voluntary leave of absence, and Capricorn decided to not pursue the investigation.
Interesting. Interesting.
I can't give you any details regarding that.
All right. Well, I think we're done here. Well, hold on. We got more here.
Carl gave me no indication of being suicidal. Of course, I hadn't seen him in over 2 months.
Ooh. Will the Joe himself show up to the stream tonight? Bet your points now for all four of you that are here. But this prediction is going to run for a little bit, so if anybody else is just popping in, got to bet on this because I have no idea. I'm hoping we see him tonight. This is the main reason we're playing this.
That company supplies us with many technologically advanced medications, including what you might call anti-aging drugs. They're very much on the cutting edge in their field.
Cutting edge, huh? So we got Sylvia Linsky, the Dear Jane note.
That young woman is trouble. I won't burden you with details. Suffice it to say that she has a way with older men and knows how to get what she wants.
Ooh. Okay.
I've never heard of it.
Fine, fine. I think we're done here. End of the conversation. So we can now go to Capricorn. Let's try.
The address Detective Clements got from Sonny Fletcher's parole officer turned out to be a filthy, vermin-infested motel. It was a dump.
Let's check
like
for
a porta potty at a chili
Sonny.
Okay, I get the point.
Oh, no.
Sorry. I just couldn't imagine why Carl Linsky would hire a detective who lived in a place like that.
He's going right to Juice Part! Yeah, but, that'd be fun. That ain't Joe.
What do you want?
Yeah, I've got some great news. Your parole officer says the cops are almost positive that you didn't kill Carl Linsky.
Hmm. What makes you think I know Carl Linsky?
That's up to you, Sonny.
Make
a reasonable
deal. I can
invite Linsky's girlfriend and your parole officer over for a game of truth or dare.
You can just humor me right now.
Let me tell you something. With that attitude of yours, I can tell that you just received your PI license, didn't you?
Well, that's what I tell all the chicks. My name's Murphy.
All right.
Yeah, that's what I tell all the ladies.
Come in, Murphy. I'll talk to you.
Nice place you got here.
Mi casa es tu casa.
And this is not Joe.
Close the door.
Shit.
Nice place.
Yeah. My travel agent got it for me.
I'd get a new travel agent.
That was not Joe I was talking to.
It's your permanent residence?
It's the hospital.
It just might be, why?
That's just... It's like you're hiding out from bill collectors or something.
I mean, if that was Joe, then he has a hell of a range in how he can just change his skin color and body type.
What do you want from me, huh?
I understand Carl Linsky had hired you. At least, before he died.
I had nothing to do with Carl Linsky buying the farm. Bible truth.
The Bible says the truth will set you free.
Oh.
What were you working on with Linsky?
Okay, I guess I can tell you now. It doesn't matter. He wanted me to find
That would be impressive. I want to see Mark just impersonate all
of them. I don't know. Man gives me a list of names and I go to work, okay?
If you don't mind me saying, why would Linsky hire you? You don't look like you're in much condition to be working.
That's low.
I haven't had a drink in almost 2 years! Until last week!
I guess you're pretty
this
thirsty
is like
by
Decker
then.
Level
you're funny,
acting.
Man! You're so funny. Jeez.
What are you working on with Linsky?
Look, I just tracked down two people, all right? It was a Val Davis and a Rona Morgan. Didn't take me any time. I found out where they were. They were in the ground, and they hadn't been there too long.
Is that when you dropped the case?
Yeah, around there. Look, I prefer not to talk about this anymore, okay?
Okay.
Gracias.
If you could just give me some more information about the names on the list.
I can't remember.
Come on, don't hold out on me.
Yeah, come on.
Want a bribe or something? You know that's illegal.
I can't remember. Bible's truth.
He's gonna do the kiss every time he says
okay,
that.
I'm gonna give it to you straight. I'm working on Linsky's suicide, and I just need some information, a clue or a lead, something to keep the thing going.
Wait a minute.
Just a little something.
All right.
Tell me to hang on to it, the bees up, in case anything happened to it.
Ah.
Just a bishop.
Mm-hmm.
The chess piece.
Anything
it's
else?
All coming together.
Just a warning. You better get off this case right now. Judgment Day is looking for me. It could look for you, too. You better get out, amigo.
I'll keep your warning in mind.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe we'll see each other around.
Yeah, maybe. Hey.
I'll shut the door.
All right, so interesting. I say, what should we do next? I know by going back to the, or wait, no, we can't, we've already ended day one. We're on day two now. So for day two's activities.
What's this? Two pieces for the price of one.
Aha! The missing piece to the card.
I'm pretty sure I know where this. He's cut up.
Drag and drop. Put the card together. Do it, Tex. Where the hell did it go? Aha! Another puzzle. Okay. We can do this. Can you rotate the pieces at least? That appears to be a negative. God damn it. I am not liking this at all. We had to do puzzles like this in Resident Evil, and I hated them there. And, hey, I still hate them now, even. So maybe these connect? Nah, that's dumb. I'm pretty sure there's a way to rotate the pieces, but I don't know how to do it. I mean, I'd certainly fucking hope you can. If I can't rotate the pieces, we're in... Or if that's not an option, we're in big trouble here. Triangle. Basic shapes, my mortal enemy. The right corner. I mean, that looks like that fits there, yeah. Now, what else goes where is the real question. I feel like that's like some shitty middle piece, I don't know. And I feel like this goes on an edge somewhere. I'm not seeing any, yeah, there's no like piece rotation here that I'm aware of, at least. Son of a bitch. Hold on 1 second. This is really bugging me, so I gotta figure it out first. Uh-huh. Yeah, I think there is some way to rotate the pieces that I can't see. Might have to look at the controls, because... Okay, there's definitely a way to rotate the pieces. We know this much. Because, like, the whole bar was a straight line. But I'm not sure how you do any of the actual rotating of the piece. It's maddening. Not the arrow keys. Ah, you gotta... Oh, that's so cursed. You gotta click it and do the arrow keys. We're in business now. $19.98 gaming for you right here. Stick together, son of a bitch. Just do it. That little sliver, it's pissing me off. Fine. I'll just assume it wants it like that, then. That's the other corner. That's further up. Yeah, that goes right there. Look at this. We're doing it. It's working. All right, all right, all right. We're not going to get any extra points for completion time, but at least we did it. Although, this trapezoid boy is fucking with me. What do you go up here? You go over there. Where do you go over here? Ha! Got him! Boom. Got pass card E. We got the pass card reader.
Well, if they use the same alphabet I do, that means there are at least five of these cards floating around. Maybe more.
God damn, and they're probably all cut up as well, aren't they? Okay. Well, we got that figured out. So now, back to Linsky's warehouse. Now, where's that damn computer?
I'll bet this computer is important, but it's got a security protect feature. I'll need to attach a pass card reader and use a security card with it before it'll operate.
Password. Let's try Bishop. Mr. Fletcher, if something has happened to me, you can be sure it was murder. Let my daughter Sylvia know. At this point, I can't say for certain who would want me dead, though it may be related to the project. The project I contracted to work on. Other than Val Davis, Rona Morgan, and Bosworth Clark, I haven't been able to find out the names of the others involved in the project. If you can track down Bosworth Clark, he may be the best bet for additional information. Also, I have an address for you to check out. Route 12, Box 4, Fresno, 9365-002. Whoever's running the project could be based there. CL for Carl Linsky. Any new places in the address book, then? Linsky's house, Dolores, warehouse, Sunny, the hospital, Texas office. I mean, I guess we could try to go back to the office, see if that triggers something, but nah. I don't think so.
I'm saving these bottles of cold duck for a special romantic dinner. All of the flavor and none of the mind-numbing alcohol.
Cold duck. Oh, wow. All right, well, we can go to Capricorn.
I dealt with Capricorn in one of my later cases, but this was the first time in the Capricorn building. I mean, the exterior was impressive, but what I saw inside was dynamite.
Some woman, I'd guess.
Oh,
well,
you
from
bet.
Your choice of metaphors,
Capricorn has all the top
to like this part of the story
futuristic San Francisco waifus. It's like Star Trek IV: Return to San Francisco. Except futuristic San Francisco. Because I forgot in Star Trek IV, they go back in time to, like, 80s San Francisco.
Wanda Peck.
Oh, it's Wanda. Can finally put a face to the name. Flattering question.
Weren't you in the Miss Universe pageant last year?
Yes. I was working undercover investigating allegations of bra theft.
Well, that's good work if you can get it. So what is a gorgeous woman like you doing in a place like this?
Why didn't you just tell me the reason for
that?
That
was Star Trek II, Search for Spock. No, it was Star Trek IV. Don't take the Greg defense on this one.
I'd like you to tell me everything you know about Carl Linsky. I'm investigating his suicide.
I read about Linsky's death. I was sad about it. But why do you want to talk to me?
Yeah.
Take a seat.
Oh, don't you take a seat, me. Looking for love.
Okay. I admit this was a pretense, but I really wanted to get your attention.
Well, now that we've met, why don't we get down to the real reason you're here?
So what do you know about old Carl?
About a year ago, we were told that Mr. Linsky was conducting unethical practices on comatose and terminally ill patients at North Hill Clinic. I looked into the matter, but was unable to prove anything. Mr. Linsky voluntarily took a leave of absence, saying he had other projects to pursue, so we decided to drop the investigation.
All right. Val Davis, what do you know about this person?
Never heard that name before.
Okay. Rona Morgan?
Can't help you there.
Son of a bitch. Capricorn.
Capricorn's primary mission is to identify, then infiltrate, organizations suspected of practicing extreme discrimination. These include everything from UFO cults to hate groups to unethical research scientists.
Okay. It's literally 1984. It's the woke police, guys. Oh no. Overlord?
I keep hearing the word overlord, especially linked to the Law and Order Party. I don't know if it's a person, place, or thing, but it seems to represent a lot of power.
Arnold Sternwood.
As the director of the clinic, he was understandably eager to avoid any scandal and was very helpful throughout our investigation of Carl Linsky.
Okay. North Hill Clinic?
As you probably know, the clinic has an outstanding reputation. We were surprised when the allegations against Carl Linsky came up.
Next page.
I don't have any information on that.
You wouldn't. Okay. De Leon Health Services?
I haven't the faintest idea what that is.
Okay. You know the daughter?
Never heard that name before.
Okay.
Can't help you there.
So yeah, you don't really have too big of a scope of things, huh?
I don't have any information on that.
And we'll ask one more thing about... Law and Order Party.
We're putting a lot of our resources into investigating Law and Order. Their legal people make sure they don't cross the line publicly, but their ideology is pretty frightening to anyone with any intelligence or belief in human rights.
I'm going to end the conversation there. Mark Prush's wife. Definitely Mark's wife. Let's go back to Linsky's house, actually. Oh,
Tex.
His actual wife, like, she's good. She's like,
let
really good looking.
For last night.
Damn, I need to see a pic. I don't think I've ever seen Mark Pritch's wife.
10% depression and 90% alcohol.
And 100% reason to remember the name.
Hopefully there's something I can do to make it up to you. If there's anything else you need, just ask.
Yeah, so we actually have a lot to go over here. I'm going to need some caffeine to continue to induct this investigation. So I'm going to take a short break, and I'll be right back. Okay, we are back. Dolores.
She's a hideous woman. If she weren't handling my father's will, I would have nothing to do with her.
Okay, so those two clearly don't like each other. Now we're getting somewhere.
If my father was planning on dumping Dolores, it wouldn't be a surprise.
DMs?
I never understood what he saw in her in the first
it's text
place.
Murphy night, so I'm going to check on my phone. Because I don't like tabbing out of that game very often. Oh, wow. Damn. Mark is fucking rolling. I like that. I like that a lot. Well, I'm... Mark has a beautiful wife. He's a very lucky man.
I don't know what that is.
Okay, I'm just asking. A main writer for the U.S. office, huh? That's fucking incredible, then. I've watched, like, every episode of The Office, so I've definitely probably seen some of her work, or all of it on that show, at least.
I'm not really interested in politics, but I can tell you my father didn't care much for the Law and Order Party.
All right, good to know. Pass card.
I don't know anything about it.
Val Davis.
Doesn't sound familiar.
Are you sure you can't tell me anything? Rona Morgan.
I've never heard of her.
Never heard of her.
My father had some kind of run-in with them a while ago, but he didn't give me any details.
Okay. The insurance policy?
So.
Yeah.
You found
tell me
policy.
About that.
Well, not that it's going to do me any good, but who knows? Maybe things will work out.
Yeah, you want that money, don't you? I see. I'm starting to put my feelers out there and make that connection. Overlord? Do you know anything
Doesn't
about Overlord?
Familiar.
And yeah, the life insurance. Let's get deeper into
I'll
this.
Admit, I could use the insurance money, but I doubt I'll ever get it.
North Hill Clinic.
That's where my father worked. He was highly respected in his profession.
Okay. And the will.
As I said, my father's will is more trouble than it's worth. My father loved chess, He used to say I'd be a good player, but I've never been interested in it.
All right, I think we're done here. Let's explore the house a little bit, because there was something to do with a chessboard. So we need to find where that was again. I just saw Joe Estevez. Did you? All the drawers are just still open.
There are only 31 pieces on the chessboard. Seems like an odd number.
Do we not have the chess piece anymore? Oh, I thought we could just put the chess piece down
here. Linsky didn't strike me as the sort of guy who'd use random profanity, no matter how much. The colonel...
Well, guess we're at a loss there. I thought that we could put like the chess piece back on the board and that would do something, but it appears not. So, I don't think there's anything else we can do here. Dolores, I feel like there's more you can tell us.
So what can I do for the world's sexiest PI?
Oh, Doris, you flatter me.
Oh, I wish I could be of more help.
I wish you could too, honey bun. But no.
I don't know who that is.
Give me something here.
That's some sort of spy organization. Carl didn't think too fondly of it for some reason. Carl's wife left soon after Sylvia was born. Oh, Carl did the best that he could, but he never felt that he'd done a very good job raising Sylvia, and she never appreciated her father. She left home when she was very young and went into some unsavory kind of work. Escorting or something like that.
Oh, you dirty bitch, just gossiping away.
They hadn't been close in years.
Getting spicy on me, Dolores.
Well, they're a bit too right-wing for me, but I do agree with many of their policies. Oh, and they have the most handsome and attractive gubernatorial candidate.
Fucking Dolores, the enlightened centrist.
I can't really help you there. Oh, it's too soon, Tex. Allow me to grieve first, and then we'll see what grows between us.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Guess we'll see about that. Damn it. Is there anybody who can be of more help to me here?
My fax machine's brand new. Now if I could just get a fax from someone other than my mom.
One day, Tex. One day.
This is the one thing that I refuse to skimp on. It's the finest cot that money can buy.
Okay, so there's nothing new it looks like in the office then.
This is the door to my walk-in.
Blacklight that room. We're not fancy enough to have black light
stuff. The
circuit
conductor kit could come in handy. Linsky must have had trouble sleeping. These prescription pills would knock out an elephant.
We could go to the video phone. Let's dial
What topic would you like us to research?
The database and see what we can find here.
A search for information on Law and Order Party.
Because at least things like Capricorn and the Law and Order Party, they're going to know about more.
A search for information on Capricorn has been initiated. What other topic would you like us to research? A search for information on DeLeon Health Services has been initiated. What other topic would you like us to research? Thank you for using the American Information Database. Goodbye.
All right, so in a little bit we'll get some faxes.
You have a fax.
You have a fax. It's like the best notification.
My fax machine's brand new. Now, if I could just get a fax from someone else.
Organized in 2032 to oppose illegal immigration, rising crime rates, and a perceived ineffectiveness of the American criminal justice system. Last year's elections resulted in 27 victories for the Law and Order Party. All at the municipal level, still a political minority, LNO is yet to win a state seat but are gaining public support, according to exit polls. Capricorn, civilian agency for the protection of the rights of individuals and the creation of order, reason, and neutrality, established 2005, New York, New York. Satellite offices located in 44 cities worldwide, privately owned and funded organization works in conjunction with the local police, FBI, and Interpol. All right. Good job, old fax machine. Oh, we're running out of leads here. Let's go back to the clinic.
Listen, Mr. Murphy, I've been cooperative, and I've answered all your questions already. I'm under no obligation to help you any further.
I'm just doing my job, Mr. Sternwood. And I know it's not as exciting or as glamorous as yours, but I could really use your help.
Fine. Get to the point. I don't know who that is.
Yeah, nobody does. God damn these people.
The name is unfamiliar.
Not being very helpful here.
I'll bet this computer is important, but it's got a security protect feature. I'll need to Pascal.
Yeah, we can't check out anything with the address, though. I figure that address would, like, show up on here. Oh, there it is, the Fresno office. How the hell did I not see that?
The Fresno address was in the heart of the hot zone, in what might have been a strip mall, at least before the bombs fell. It seemed pretty obvious the place was a front, a red herring meant to throw off any passing bloodhounds. But I'd made the trip, so I decided to check it out.
Maybe not always as it seems. Oh, that's the exit. Okay.
There are three different appointments. Dinner on Monday in San Francisco at 6 p.m. Lunch on Tuesday in Paris at 2 p.m.
Damn.
Breakfast in Sydney on
Travel's
Thursday
really improved
9
in the future.
I hope this person can keep track of time zones. And what's this note about? Three sets of three. It must be important.
Three sets of three.
It's a map of the world with three different time zones highlighted.
Four a.m., one p.m., ten a.m.
Looks like there were a few packing boxes left over from the move.
Nothing we can move here.
A handsome display of commemorative plates. Interesting. Looks like the plates can be rotated.
Uh-huh.
That's a nice rendering of the Golden Gate Bridge.
The plates can be rotated, huh? Well, why aren't we rotating them? Aha! Here we go. What have we here?
A safe. And it appears to be connected somehow to the commemorative plate display.
Three sets of three. And then we have the note, or the planner, rather.
There are three different appointments. Dinner on Monday in San Francisco at 6 p.m., lunch on Tuesday in Paris at 2 p.m., breakfast in Sydney on Thursday at 9 a.m. I hope this person can keep track of time zones. And what's this note about? Three sets of three.
San Francisco at 6 p.m., 2 p.m. lunch in Paris, and Thursday breakfast in Sydney at 9 a.m. Okay, so San Francisco. Two PM. Paris at six. Sydney at 9 AM. What?
A safe.
Didn't do anything.
It appears to be connected somehow to the commemorative. There are three different appointments.
San Francisco 6, Paris 2. Excuse me? Damn it. What the hell? Am I going to have to set them all to local time? I guess let's look at the time zones. So this would be the San Francisco time zone, like right here. So if we set them all to San Francisco time, this one would still be 6 p.m. If we adjust Paris time, Paris at 2 p.m. So would be 5 a.m. in San Francisco. So Paris at 2 would be 5, so we've got 6 p, 5 a. So 10 p.m. is 4 a.m. in Sydney. 9 would be 3. And it would be 3 p.m. in Frisco. So, man, I'm already confusing myself. 6 P. Oh, God damn it. 6 P for San Francisco. That's the one we already know, right? And then Paris at 2 p.m. would be 5 a.m. in Frisco. So 6 P, 5 A, and then 3P. Okay. I think I got this. Let's try it this way. Six P, okay. Would be 5A, and then holy fuck, so it's not adjusted time.
A safe. And it appears to be connected somehow to the commemorative plate display. There are three
sets of three. Thought maybe three sets of three, but which three? 3A or 3P? I'm not liking the clock puzzle. Three sets of three. Oh, you got to do it like three different times and in different orders. Ooh. Tex. Oh, you son of a bitch. It crashed on me when I tabbed out. Oh, no. Fuck, and this shit doesn't autosave. Oh, holy hell. Oh, no, we're where we were. Thank goodness. It's Alt-R. Jeez. Pretty sure it's Alt-R. Okay, so we'll save over that, and I gotta look at this chart one more time.
Hey guys.
Cause you gotta adjust each one in like order three different times, so.
A handsome display of commemorative plates. Interesting. And it appears to be connected somehow to the commemorative plate.
So San Francisco to 6, P, Paris, 3A, Sydney, so that did one of them, and then set Paris, 2P, San Francisco, 5 a.m., and then Sydney, 11 p.m. Did it not do it right? So we set Paris to 2 p.m. Sydney to 11, or wait, San Francisco to 5. And then Sydney, yeah, to 11 p.m. There we go. Then Sydney goes to 9A. San Francisco to 3P. Then Paris to 12A. There, that opened it. Thank goodness. I had it halfway figured out, but that would have taken me hours to get like from there to here. So I'll take it. So the safe's open. What do we got in here? Joe Estevez clue.
A photo of Carl Linsky's.
Oh, there's Joe!
Finding a safe in an abandoned office.
We got him!
Hot zone. Something tells me I need to find out who the other guy in the photo is.
That's Joe Estevez, Tex. I mean, there he is. He's right there. Fucking Joe, look at him. Perfection. We got him, boys. Soak it up. We've had our first Joe Estevez sighting. Very good stuff.
Now, why would they leave a perfectly good bookcase behind? A photo.
Yeah, you didn't see it? This guy right here?
I'd expect to find in a safe in an abandoned office in the middle of a hot zone. Looks like there were a few packing boxes left over from the move. Looks like there were a few packing boxes left over from the move. It's a map of the world with three different time zones highlighted. Looks like there were a few packing boxes left over from the move. Looks like mail still being delivered to this address.
Old Sparky Electric Co., huh? We take one last spin around here. I don't think there's much else I can really find. So after, what do we do after that part, I wonder? Okay. So, we gotta talk to Sonny.
When I returned to Sonny's motel room, he wasn't there, but he'd left a letter for me, taped to the door.
All right, we got a letter from Sonny, huh? Murphy, I warned you to get off the Linsky case, and I didn't tell you why. But you have a right to know. A long time ago, believe it or not, I was like you. Young, driven, invincible. I got caught up in an investigation that was too big for me. Cost me the most precious thing in my life. My wife was murdered by a man who calls himself Jim Slade. For me, he was the angel of death. I've lived in fear and shame ever since, but have tried to find reasons to go on. Not long ago, I was tracking down the names on the Linsky, or that Linsky gave me, and got a lead on the whereabouts of someone named Bosworth Clark. I ended up near an old Anasazi ruin, about 40 miles southwest of Tucson. Something was waiting for me there, a sign from the Angel of Death. A sign that I'm sure he meant for me to find. And at that moment, I knew that my judgment day was drawing near. Meeting you made me take a hard look at myself. I've decided it's time I faced my demon. Slade feeds on fear, but not this time. I intend to avenge what he did to me, or die trying. I know my very words of caution will fall on deaf ears. I may still remember what it was to be young. I only ask you to do one thing. Don't end up like me, Sonny Fletcher. All right, Sonny. Well, thanks for that. We can go to the Anasazi ruin, I guess. It's an interesting place for the investigation to go to. What are we, Indiana Jones now? We're supposed to be Tex Murphy, for God's sakes. And the Overseer. All right, let's check out what do we got here. We need to get to our big deductive height. We can't successfully investigate anything if we're running around all my size.
This door doesn't open. I'll have to find another way in.
What the hell would Linsky have been looking at here? So nothing to say about the box text, huh? You disappoint me. Brick 2. Oh, more puzzles afoot. Oh, nice. You can just clip right through the door. I don't have to worry about ducking. And a pipe. Tex is about to start laying that pipe down. Oh, shit. A small pot. And brick number 2. A lot of things to be picking up. Vine on a stick. Looked like a slingshot to me, but yeah, vine on a stick.
Interior decorating, and decorating, Anasazi style.
Anasazi.
I have no idea what this is, but it's probably important. Maybe something around here can tell me about it.
Okay.
Hey, guys.
Hey, moist.
Well, there's no apparent way to open this door. Maybe it's connected somehow to that weird thing on the other wall.
We've taken a little bit of a turn here. Now we're in Anasazi ruins, apparently. Because this has to do with the Linsky murder. We saw Joe. You want to see Joe?
A photo of Linsky is about the last thing I'd expect to find in a safe in an abandoned office in the middle of a hot zone. Something tells me I need to find out who the other guy in the photo is.
My God, it's the guy from Fortnite. I wish if Joe Estevez was in Fortnite, I would start playing Fortnite. I want those On Cinema Fortnite skins. I mean, yeah, fucking Tex is a skull of steel. He doesn't care about crouching or having to duck. He's just trying to find those bricks. Violators will be thrown to the snakes. So I've got a lot of bricks, but I don't know what to do with them yet. I mean, maybe that's how Tex gets the bricks. He just walks through all of the walls and shit, and they just all fall down, crumble up. Oh, a guide to hieroglyphs. The Brick Altar. Inside one of the chambers is a special altar. The ceremony performed required 8 god bricks. Each had a different deity painted on them. According to legend, a deep secret would be revealed to anyone who could ensure that no brick was in line with another, either horizontally, vertically, or diagonally. This would allow each god to be the master of their own domain. Okay. Interesting. Man, every time I keep hearing that screech, I'm almost expecting like the cliched Western theme in the wah, wah, wah. We got some short poles, some pipe. Fucking Tex laying all the pipe.
Ceremonial chamber. One of the earliest forms of nightclubs known to man. Whoa, that snake doesn't look very friendly. And it doesn't look like it's going to move away from that brick anytime soon. Maybe I can bait it into moving.
Okay, Tex, what do you propose? Vine on a stick.
Well, that won't work.
You're not trying hard enough. Sleeping pills. Give him some sleeping pills.
Well, that's not going to work.
Pipe him.
Doesn't seem to do anything.
Well, I'm just thinking out loud. Lay the pipe.
Well, that won't work.
All right. Well, our answers are elsewhere. Oh, those snake sounds scared me a little bit. He doesn't look like he's much in a talking mood. Our little snake friend there. Oh, Tex can run. Hell yeah. Now I feel like I'm speed running.
This well's drier than Grandma's meatloaf and a little too deep for comfort. I'd better not jump down there, or I may be here a lot longer than planned. I can't quite reach that.
Oh, come on, Tex. It's fine. Just fall in.
There's a bucket down there with a brick in it. If I can find something to hook onto the bucket handle with, I could take a closer look at the brick.
Hook this pipe on
there. This won't work by itself.
Can't combine those, no. All right, well, back to the old drawing board.
Well, I'm no expert on Anasazi culture, but it looks to me like I'll have to line up the red dots on the cogs to the corresponding red marks on the wall.
Okay. Got one red dot to line up, but just not the other two. Shit. Okay. Oh, Batros, welcome Raiders. What's going on, everybody? You've caught me in a moment of deductive puzzle thinking here, but we are playing Tex Murphy Overseer. We have had our first Joe Estevez sighting, but it was only a clue from a photograph. We haven't even got to interact with Joe yet. We're hoping that somehow through, I guess, an Anasazi temple, we're going to find a lead that gets us to Joe, maybe. We'll have to see. All right. What am I doing here? So, our goal here is to get all of these red dots here to line up with these red dots. Got to play your first FMV game just recently and finished it yesterday. That's awesome. What did you play for your first FMV experience? I'm curious. Oh, we got these two really close. Look at that. And the third one's lined up. You gotta be kidding me. Contradiction. Masterpiece of a game. I'll have to look into that. That sounds very intriguing. Man, I've almost got it to where these three are synced up. But not quite. $8,000 budget, insanely impressive. Wow, that small of a budget. I'm definitely going to have to give out an old looky-loo sometime. Oh, I didn't mean to click that one. So close, yet so far away. Need to get this one on the right on like the same wavelength as the other two. And then maybe I've got a shot. Let's go two on this side. And then one here. And then another. Son of a bitch. Man, I'm not even been close on this one. Out of free time. This puzzle is brutal. I know, it's hard to keep track of how many each one of the gears moves with each of the levers. I can get one or two lined up, but not all three. And I'm sure that, if I fucking look this up, hold on. Or no, not that. Anyway. I've had to look up a couple of these, because this is just fucking... Puzzles and games anymore don't compare to what they were in the days of Tex Murphy here. Oh, do the levers actually move? Like, as you pull them, do they progressively move? Pull the middle level into two. The right lever into six. Left lever into one.
Right lever and descent. Oh, they each, I didn't even notice this. They move, you pull them up and you pull them down. I thought you just pulled them down on each one. So now I kind of get what it's telling me. With like, because it had a diagram with like the 1-6 thing. I wasn't even paying attention to how the levers themselves moved. Okay. So we need to push the middle lever up is our first move. That's down. Ah, so you click up and down to hit the lever each way. Oh. Let's exit and start it over. Yeah, I pull it in the order, even the guide says, and that seems to not be working the way that I thought it would. Let's just exit, we'll restart. So the middle goes into 2. That puts everything there. Okay. Right into 6. Left into 1. Right into 6. Oh, fuck. That's wrong. Yeah, that doesn't actually solve it. I get a better idea of this, though. So... okay. Damn it. That somehow got it. That wasn't even the right order. Okay, figured it out. How about that? Game Boomer guide can suck my nuts, I guess. Although, if it weren't for that guide, I wouldn't have figured out that the levers were moving in 2 different directions and that affected, like, the rotation. That's... that was brutal. But for the sake of getting things done in a reasonable amount of time, I had to look that one up. But I'm still enjoying Tex Murphy. I think in the future,
you're decorating in a Sozzy style.
I'll be playing like the newer Tex Murphy game that just came out recently, like a couple years ago or so. Because apparently it's got like the same actors and everything for the most part, like playing Tex and the main cast. So I think that would be very fun to play through. Tex gives no fucks, just walks right through walls. But we're not done yet. No. We've only got how many of our bricks? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We don't even have all the bricks yet. We got 5 out of 8. I know where 6 and 7 are. But not 8. Can we make a trap? We can. I thought maybe the vine, the rope, and the box would make a trap. And that's what we'll do for the snake. There we go. I figured, why are we walking around with an empty box if we're not supposed to put stuff in it or anything like that? All right, Rattler. Yeah, you keep getting pissed. Just you wait. I've got a trap with no bait.
Well, that's not going to work.
What do you mean? It's definitely going to work.
That doesn't seem to do anything.
We're going to trap the fucking Rattler, Tex.
Well, that won't work.
Where the hell do you want me to put it? Like, far away? Where's the snake gonna go?
Well, that's not gonna work.
You're bringing me down, Tex.
That doesn't seem to do anything.
Maybe it will if you just give it a chance.
Well, that won't work. Ceremonial chamber. One of the earliest forms of nightclubs known to man.
Wasn't asking about the chamber.
Whoa. That snake doesn't look very friendly. And it doesn't look like it's going to move away from that brick anytime soon. Maybe I can bait it into moving.
Okay, so we're back to square one. I don't know what to do with the snake trap. I mean, this has to be for the snake. Right. And I don't know of any other items I would have that would help in baiting it. So. Kind of back where we started on this. Like, I'm half-assedly getting my answers a little bit at a time. This needs to be a little faster. I guess all that extra architecture over there is only for show. Man, what's gonna bait the snake?
The circuit can. This door doesn't open. I'll have to find another way in.
Just this one tiny area, huh? It's not making much sense. The snake thing's fucking weird to me. Oh. A mouse. Now where the hell am I going to find a mouse? All right, Tex. I guess we're looking for mice.
Interior decorating, Anasazi style. This door doesn't open.
I'll have to find another way in. The holes in the walls are the same size as the bricks I found with the Anasazi drawings on them. I'm guessing that 8 bricks inserted into the correct openings will cause something cool to happen. Now, there's no apparent way to open this door. Maybe interior decorating, Anasazi style.
Damn it. So now we're on the hunt for rats. Well, I'm thinking they're still going to be on the ground, so I'm going to keep my eyes low. See if we can't just find a rat or two.
Not what you'd call lush bucket down there with a brick in it. If I can find something to hook onto the bucket handle with, I could take a closer look at the brick. Not what you'd call lush vegetation.
No, it most certainly is not lush. Good observation, Tex. Okay, so where the fuck is this rat? Mouse. I mean, I don't have a mouse in my inventory. Who the fuck just has a mouse? Thought you just find it. And even some of the guides are like, yeah, they don't even mention the fucking, like, where to find the mouse. They just assume you've already got it. But where the fuck else would I just be picking up mice? Like, come on. Once I figure it out, it's going to be, like, so obvious where it was at the whole time. Oh, I swear I've looked about everywhere, though. Uh-huh. Huh. Still thinking, I guess, is it behind this sign? Can the sign be moved? I know there's been stuff like that before, but it doesn't seem to be. Doesn't seem to be the play here.
Ceremonial chamber. One of the earliest forms of nightclubs known to man.
The hell is that? Rope. Yucca rope. Rope and pipe. Okay, so that's my hook, at least, for the brick that's in the well. Let's see if we can get that first. Alright, alright. We're getting closer.
Well, that's not gonna work.
Why the fuck not, Tex? You know it will.
There's a bucket down there with a brick in it. If I can find something to hook onto the bucket handle with, I could take a closer look at the brick.
There. Got brick 7.
Not what you'd call lush vegetation.
No, I was just looking any dead mice in here or stuff like that I could pick up. No? Damn you, game. Making me look around for rats and shit. Thought I was supposed to be like a PI, but now I'm doing Indiana Jones shit. Huh. Well, I got a little more time here, so it's just, I'm gonna look up where the mouse is at, or try to. For some reason, I cannot find that. Uh-huh. God damn it, some of these walkthroughs are so old. The toy mouse? Where do you even find a toy mouse? What? Hold on. Bottom left drawer filing cabinet.
Hey guys.
Huh. So we missed it. We missed the toy mouse in like a filing cabinet somewhere. So we're actually gonna have to go back and find that.
Hey guys.
Hey Moist. So for now, we'll go back to the office. It's been a long day. So one of those damn filing cabinets we missed. Oh, if Tex's file cabinets are empty, so it's not in his office. But that's all right. It is getting kind of late for me. So I think this might be a good stopping off point for tonight. Go ahead and save in a new slot. And then I guess all that leaves us to do here is find a raid for tonight. I doubt anybody's playing any of the Tex Murphy games, but we can at least take a little spin around retro and see all who's on tonight. All right, what do we got? Anybody playing some FMV Madness? Oh, okay. So Moist has a raid for us. Artorias Veo with 7. Okay. Got 7 raiders getting ready to pop in to Artorias Veo. Go ahead and show them some love from the Uncle Vatred community. I hope I'm not butchering that name, but I guess we will find out here shortly. As for me, I'll be back tomorrow. It'll be KOTOR 2 Negative Influence Run. So I hope to see you all there. Otherwise, have a good rest of your morning, afternoon, or evening. I'm out.